Hello, I'm Brian Parks from Belimo Technical Support here at the Belimo headquarters in Danbury, Connecticut. Today, I want to talk about the Belimo PS100 power supply and signal generator. Sometimes when we get a call from a customer and they're having an issue with a Belimo actuator, we'll ask them to remove the actuator from the building management system and the building power supply, and we'll ask them to hook up to the PS100. This way, we can determine if the building management system is what's causing the problem with the actuator. All right, so here we have our Belimo PS100 power supply, and I'm going to go through what each of these buttons and knobs is for, and I'll show you how to use it. Before we do that, let's start with the transformer that comes with the PS100. So this right here is a 110-volt AC transformer that will convert the signal to 24 volts AC. I have this little plug here. I'm gonna plug it into the side before I put it into the 110 volts. It's just a good practice to do that so that we don't cause any damage to the PS100 or the transformer. I would also say at this time, the transformer is rated for 30 VA or 30 volt amps, and it's also rated for 30 watts. That information is listed on the label here. I'm gonna take and plug this into the 110 outlet. I come back over here. Here's the power supply switch. I'm going to turn it on. We see the little light lights up. And I'm going to leave that off for now. Let's start with the first two posts right here. And the very first one is a common. The very next one is a 24 volt hot. And what that's for is this gives a constant 24 volt power out to the actuator. And it's not changeable. It's a steady 24 volts. The next three posts are for the 135 ohm slide wire. I've got a knob here and I've got these three black buttons that are related to that. The very first one is marked CCW for counterclockwise. The center one has an arrow pointing up. And then we have a clockwise for the final post. And if you wire it up, of course, leave the power off, wire it up. When you turn the power on, if you turn this knob all the way to the counterclockwise position, the actuator should turn counterclockwise, and so on. We turn it to clockwise, should turn. The next four posts are related to the proportional control signal. And so what I have here is I have a common and a 24 volt. These two posts are exactly the same as the first two in the beginning here. These are a steady 24 volt output signal that are hooked up to the actuator, and you cannot change that 24 volt signal. This next one is for the control signal from this PS100 out to the actuator. This button here is for feedback in, and that's gonna be what we receive back from the actuator. I'll talk about these other knobs and switches in a moment. And what we have on the end here is tri-state or floating point control, and very similar to the first one, we have counterclockwise, common, and clockwise. And we have a little selector switch. It's on clockwise. I can turn it off completely, or I can turn it to counterclockwise like that. All right, so now let's go ahead and wire up an actuator, and I'll show you how to use the proportional control signal. The actuator that I selected today is the Belimo NFB24-SR. This particular damper actuator is a proportional control 24 volt spring return actuator. The SR in this nomenclature actually stands for proportional, and it's the letter F that tells me that it's a spring return. If you would like more information on understanding the Belimo nomenclature, you can go to www.belimo.us and you can find an explanation of how to understand what the different letters and numbers stand for. So again, it's a 24 volt. So I'm able to use the PS100 power supply. It puts out a 24 volt power signal. And I want you to look on this black portion of the wiring here. And we have a number one, which is the common or negative. I have the number two, which is positive or 24 volt hot. I have the number three, which is a letter Y. And that is the control signal in from the building management system or the PS100 in this case. And the very last one is a number five, and it's got a letter U, and that's the feedback wire that goes out from the actuator back to the building management system, or today, to the PS100. To wire this up, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go to my wires, And on this particular actuator, the wires actually have numbers on them. The black one has a number 1, the red has a number 2, the white has a number 3, the orange a number 5. And you have to be careful because it is possible that you may get an actuator where the colors don't match the standard wiring schematic. And so you want to verify before you hook them up exactly what it is that you're hooking up. I'm going to take and press down on this button, and I'm going to insert the wire. I release the button, it's spring-loaded, and it holds the wire in place. Next thing is the 24-volt hot. I'm going to put the wire, the white wire, on the signal generator side, and then this is the orange wire is going to go to feedback. So first thing I do, I turn the power on. I'm getting 0 volts output. The actuator doesn't do anything. So what's happening right now, I've got a 24-volt signal that is powering the actuator, but because I have nothing on my control signal, nothing happens on the actuator. This particular actuator is also a 2-to-10-volt control signal actuator. And so this knob here is the control for the signal. As I turn it up and I get above 2 volts, the actuator begins to move. I'm going to turn it all the way to 10 volts because I want this to go to full open. And as you notice, the numbers are raising up. I've got 10 volts going out in the control signal on the white wire, and this actuator is going to move to the full open position. Okay, the actuator has moved to the full open position, and I'm going to come over to these two switches here. So I've got it set on volts, output. I'm putting out 10 volts, and that's the signal that's going to the actuator. So what I want to do is I want to know what the feedback wire is saying. So I put it on feedback. Now I'm seeing how many volts are going through the unit and coming back to the signal generator. And it's about 9.90. We're going to have a little bit of a voltage drop as it goes through the unit. And if I want to know how far open is the actuator, I turn it to percent. This tells me the percent open. And if you notice, it is for a 2-to-10 signal. I'm on the feedback wire, and I'm at, it says 98%. It's pretty close to 100%. Again, we're losing just a little bit as it goes through the actuator. Okay, let's take a look at this switch down here on the actuator. Right now, it's pointing to the left, and that position, it says Y equals 0 with an arrow, and the arrow indicates the rotation with a 0 signal, or in this case, a 2-volt signal. So that means, in this position, it will rotate in a counterclockwise position on a 0, or in this case, again, 2-volt signal. If you take the crank that comes with the actuator, you'll see in the end is a little Torx bit. Put the Torx bit in, I turn it, now I'm pointing to Y equals 0, and it has a clockwise rotation. And so what that means is, in a 0, or in this case, again, a 2-volt signal, the actuator will rotate in that direction. I'm going to put it back because we don't want to leave it there. We want it to run in this position. It has happened in Belimo tech support. We'll get a phone call from a customer and they'll say that my actuator is behaving in the opposite direction. It's turning in the opposite direction than what I want. And what they're saying is on a 10-volt signal, the actuator closes. On a 2-volt signal, it opens. And we'll direct them to this switch on the face of the actuator. And they just need to change the rotation of this switch, and it'll fix the problem. Now, there are some building management systems that call for a reverse acting actuator, and that's fine if that's what you need. Now, as I said earlier, this is a spring return actuator, and on a loss of power, I'm going to kill the power here, on a loss of power, this will spring closed, or it will fail closed. Now, I also could have given it a 2-volt signal, and it would have moved to the closed position. It would have done the same thing. Today, I'm not going to talk about the how to wire up 135-ohm slide wire or the tri-state control. We don't see as many of these control systems in place anymore, and it's really more common to see the proportional actuators, which is what Belimo probably has the most of also. If you have any questions about how to wire up these other two control signals, Call us in Belimo Technical Support at 1-800-543-9038, or you can go to the Belimo website at www.belimo.us, and you can find the information there. Please subscribe to the Belimo YouTube channel and leave any questions that you have below. Thank you for watching.